Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. I'm home. Sorry it's been so long, but I couldn't get away. I know neither of you is around to hear this, but I miss you. I miss watching Dad grade papers on the living room table. I miss the three of us huddled around the radio, listening to the Silver Shroud. Dad, you were right about what living underground would really be like. 25 years locked in with the same people was a challenge. But watching them pair up, get married, have children, well, I think I got to know a little bit of what you and Mom were always telling me. Well, since I'm doing this whole trip down memory lane, maybe a walk over to the old high school is in order.
Thank you. I think it is? No? Is it then? Nanny, tell you a story. Are you not?
Oui.
Please, gather around now and listen closely. Are you cozy? Good.
Once upon a time, there were three little pigs who left home to make their fortunes and see the world. The first little pig built his home out of straw because it was fast and cheap, and then he could go off and play. The second pig built a modest house out of sticks and wood, which was still quick and cheap, but offered more protection from the cold. The third pig built a house out of bricks, for even though it would take time and money, it would be sturdy and last for many years. The third pig also purchased a General Atomics International Mr. Andy robot to help with daily chores around the house, which is a sound investment. One day, a hungry wolf came across the house made of straw and smelled the dirty little pig inside because it had no Miss Nanny to help bathe it. Little pig, let me in, said the wolf. Not by the hair on my chinny chin chin, replied the pig. So the wolf huffed and he puffed and he blew the house down and the pig ran off to join his brother in the house of sticks. The wolf came across the house of sticks and wood and smelled the two little pigs inside. Little pigs, let me in, he shouted. Not by the hairs on our chinny chin chins, replied the pigs. So the wolf huffed and he puffed and he blew their house down and the pigs ran off to join their brother in the house of bricks. Now the wolf came to the house made of bricks. Little pigs, let me in, or I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house down, he said. Not by the hairs on our chinny chin chins, replied the three little pigs. The wolf huffed, and he puffed, but no matter what, he could not blow down the brick house. So he got an idea, and climbed onto the roof of the house. The wolf climbed down the chimney. But the pigs were waiting with a pot of boiling water over the fireplace. The wolf fell in, and the third little pigs, Mr. Andy, made a delicious wolf stew for them to eat. The end.
Yeah. her food processor dolces have finally cooled down enough to work again. I've set them up to make cans of stew using the ingredient containers spread around the factory. Machines make a hell of a racket, so you'll probably get some unwanted guests.
Ugh.